You shouldn't launch rockets through lightning. Seems pretty obvious, right? Well, there was a time when maybe it wasn't so obvious. Let's talk about Apollo 12.
Go for deploy. 100 feet, lift it to the right, roll. Hold back right.
Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon. Welcome back to 2 Minute Tuesday, which is where we cover a space or science topic briefly for about 2 minutes or as close as I can get to it every Tuesday. So be sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. So let's jump right into it and put 2 minutes on the clock and get to today's 2 Minute Tuesday. Watching rocket launches is exciting and sometimes frustrating, especially if there's a weather delay, but a lot of weather criteria comes from experiences on prior flights. One of those was Apollo 12, which was struck by lightning not once, but twice during flight. Now, Apollo 12 didn't actually launch into the middle of a natural lightning storm. Instead, it actually launched through thick, overcast skies, but it suffered from what is known as rocket-induced lightning, which can occur when conditions are right and the exhaust from the rocket essentially becomes one giant lightning rod. 36 seconds into the flight of Apollo 12, the vehicle was struck by lightning, causing the fuel cells to disconnect from the main power bus as a safety measure. The capsule was able to continue running some systems on battery power, but the capsule immediately lit up like a Christmas tree with warning lights, causing a few moments of panic as they lost instrumentation and telemetry. Sixteen seconds later, the vehicle was struck again, this time causing the capsule computer to perform a guidance realignment, and the astronauts began seeing their gimbal go crazy. It was a quick-thinking ground controller named John Aaron that is quite possibly the only reason that the mission wasn't aborted. He had previously seen bad telemetry data caused by the signal conditioning equipment, or SCE. This is a system that collected data from the onboard sensors and prepared that data for the outgoing telemetry streams, as well as the onboard displays. About a minute after the initial strike, John Aaron called out a famous call.
Hey, Tom, what do you see? Well, he comes out, SCE to AUX. Say again, SCE to AUX. Oh, SCE to AUX.
Auxiliary point.
SCE to AUX, Captain. What's that?
Apollo 12 Houston, try SCE to auxiliary, over.
NCE auxiliary. What the hell is that?
SCE, SCE to auxiliary.
What's that, Tom? We got it back. Okay.
This caused the SCE to reinitialize itself and restored telemetry and instrumentation so the flight could continue. In the end, though, one takeaway was that the weather conditions for launch needed more scrutiny. Prior to this, the idea that the rocket itself could generate lightning was unheard of. After this launch, a number of rules were added to avoid causing rocket-induced lightning and account for the fact that even if there's not lightning now, there might be after launch.
I'm not sure we can get hit by lightning. I think we need to do a little more all-weather testing. Hey, that's one of the better sims, believe me.
We've had a couple of cardiac arrests down here too, Pete.
So that's this week's 2 Minute Tuesday. Did we go over? I feel like we went over. That felt like a long one this time. Whatever, close enough, you get the idea. If you have other burning space questions or topics you want me to cover, drop them in the comments down below. As always, don't forget to click the like button, consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye. Launched through thick overclassed, overclassed? Thick overclassed, overclassed. 2 minutes on the clock. What did I just do with my hands?
Ooh, 2 minutes.
2 minutes. 2 minutes on the clock.